To limit a user's available applications and settings through a kiosk, simply log into your Sonim Cloud account and click on Resources. Next, click on the plus sign by kiosk. Enter a descriptive name. Next, select your mode. Work mode is typically the only option. Then select your device model. Based on the model selected, the next three sections will populate. The general applications list shows preloaded or popular applications. To allow access to an application, simply click to highlight the name of the application. Be sure to control click to select multiples. If you'd like to add a PTT application, select it in the PTT applications. If your PTT application is not listed, it will need to be entered as a custom package down below. If you'd like to allow Sonim applications, select them in the Sonim applications list. Custom package names is where you would list applications you've installed on the device that were not preloaded. They're listed by application ID. You can generally look up an application ID by going to play.google.com. Once on the details of an application, look up in the address bar. Everything to the right of the ID equals is typically the application ID. In this example for Sonim SOS, the application ID is com.sonim.scout.sos. Copy paste that application ID into the custom package names. Be sure to comma separate additional applications. Now that you have your applications identified, you can choose what order the icons show up on the kiosk lock screen by rearranging in the app icon order section. The icons will be displayed three across, beginning with the first application at the top of the icon order list. The first application will be displayed in the upper left corner, second one will be the middle top row, and the third will be the upper right top row. Fourth application will begin the second row, and so forth. You can move the icons by selecting an application and then using the up and down arrows to move them around appropriately. Once you have your app icon order established, you can move on to the next section. You will create an exit PIN code as an administrator. This will allow you to unlock a kiosk directly on a device without having to interact with the cloud portal. The PIN code must be 4 to 8 digits long and only contain numbers. If you would like to enforce kiosk mode all the time, 24/7, be sure to check the always on status. Otherwise, you may enter a start and end time when the kiosk will be enforced. Outside of these hours, the kiosk will be removed. Next is the user interface. For notifications, Show All will show notifications just for the apps on the kiosk, such as missed calls or missed messages. Selecting None will no longer display notifications. Next is the kiosk label. You can choose No Label or select a unique identifier for each device. The options are IMEI, phone number, cloud device name, which is the name you would have given each device upon adding them to the devices section. Custom will give you an additional field where you can enter your own custom information. This will no longer be unique and will be the same on all of your devices. The app icon highlight color is the color that borders the application icon as you are moving between apps on the screen. The default is red, but you may choose a different color. Next is the emergency calling. By default, emergency calling is enabled with one-click emergency calling. This will allow a user to make an emergency call simply by tapping or clicking the emergency call button on the bottom of the kiosk screen. To disable one-click, simply deselect the box and accept the prompt. This will no longer be a one-click operation. It will require an additional step. If you would like to disable emergency calling entirely, simply click the big blue enabled button and accept the prompt. This will disable emergency calling and remove the emergency calling button from the screen. The re-enter timer allows you to re-enter the kiosk after a certain number of minutes. It is optional, as you may enter the kiosk on the device directly by going into the Scout application, scroll down to kiosk mode, and follow the prompt to re-enter the kiosk. The advanced settings allows you to give your user access to toggle airplane mode on and off, as well as use the flashlight or torch. Once your settings are complete, simply click the Add button to create the profile. Now that your profile is complete, be sure to add it to a device or a device group in the Devices section. Thank you for watching. For more resources, visit sonimtech.com.